Hello students, this video is the part 2 of the topic instantaneous center method of velocity analysis. In this video we will continue with the basics of the instantaneous center method and also discuss about the Kennedy's theorem. Before moving ahead, let us recapitulate the concepts which were discussed in the part 1 of the video. We discussed about the velocity analysis. What is velocity analysis? By velocity analysis, we mean that if the input velocity characteristics of any one of the links of a planar mechanism are specified, then we should be able to determine the velocity characteristics, linear or angular, of all other links of the same mechanism. Next, we discussed what was translation motion. In translation motion, all the points on the rigid body will have identical motion, something like this. Further, we discussed about the pure rotational motion. In pure rotational motion, there will be difference between the motion of two points on the same rigid body. So it is something like this. Next, we saw the combined rotary and translation motion in which the body is having translatory as well as rotary motion, something like this. Next, find the instantaneous center. So, for any rigid body in a plane motion, there exists a point on the rigid body or in the plane of motion whose instantaneous velocity is zero. So, this point was defined as the instantaneous center, or the I center is the center of rotation of the moving body relative to another body. We also said here that instantaneous center may lie inside the physical boundary of the rigid body or outside the physical boundary also, but it has to be in the plane of motion of the rigid body. Next, we proved that at I center, the velocity should be zero. Now, we shall prove that the I center is the center of rotation for a body as a whole. So, for this, we take a body PQ and suppose it is having both translatory and rotary motion as a general motion like this, and it reaches the point P1 Q1. Further, we join P to P1 as the point P is moved to P1 and Q point has moved to Q1. Next, what we do is that we draw the perpendicular bisectors of these two lines PP1 and Q1. For doing that, suppose first we draw the perpendicular bisector of PP1. For doing this, we take a distance on our compass which should be greater than half of PP1. Greater than half of PP1. So, by taking this distance on compass, now we draw the arcs from point P1 above PP1 like this and below PP1 like this. With a similar distance on the compass, we draw the arcs from point P1 to cut the previous arcs like this. So we get two points. So as we join these two points, this one and this one, we get the perpendicular bisector of PP1 as this. By similar method, we can draw the perpendicular bisector of QQ1 like this. These two will intersect at point I. Now, for this I to be the I center, this link or the all the points of the link PQ should have rotated as a whole about point I. So prove that, we'll try to draw the arcs by taking center I from P and from Q. So the arc from P should reach Q1 and the arc from Q should reach Q1 with the center I. So we take I as center and we draw the arc from P to P1. It is perfectly okay. Similarly, from Q to Q1 we draw an arc. So the same, these two arcs are concentric. So we can say that the whole link or whole body PQ have rotated around, about the center I. So I can be termed as the I center of this configuration. So we have already joined P to I and I to Q. Further, we see that the linear velocity of point P, VP, is equal to the angular velocity of P about I multiplied by the distance between P and I. So this gave us VP is equal to omega into IP. Omega is the angular velocity. Similarly, we can write that VQ is equal to omega into IQ. So we have VP upon IP is equal to VQ upon IQ is equal to omega. This is the similar equation which we obtained earlier. If suppose there is a point R on this link PQ, then we can also write that VP upon IP is equal to VQ upon IQ is equal to VR upon IR. Now, having proved the I center in both the ways, as velocity is also zero at I center and also it is the center of rotation of a link as a whole. Now we shall learn how to name the instantaneous centers or about giving notations to the ICs. An I center is the center of rotation of a moving body relative to another body. Now let us consider two bodies, P and Q. If a body P is having motion relative to the fixed body Q, then the center of rotation IC may be named as IPQ. However, in case of relative motion, the body Q can also be imagined to have relative motion about the same center, assuming P to be fixed for that instant. Thus, center of rotation IC can be named as IQP also. Moving ahead, now let us define relative instantaneous center. If two moving bodies P and Q are in relative motion, then we can define a relative instantaneous center IPQ as a point on body Q having zero relative velocity with respect to coincident point on body P. We saw earlier that IC may be a point on body Q having zero relative velocity with respect to a coincident point on body P. So we can say that IPQ is equal to IQP. Further, we can also say that the absolute instantaneous center of the velocity is the relative instantaneous center with respect to the fixed link. Now, we shall discuss about the number of ICs any mechanism can have. For two bodies having relative motion between them, there is an I center. Thus, in a mechanism, the number of I centers will be equal to possible pairs of bodies or links. That is, for small n link mechanism, there can be total n I centers taken two links at a time, given by capital N is equal to n into n minus 1 upon 2, where small n is the number of links and capital N is the number of I centers. Now, let us discuss how by inspection of a mechanism we can find the relative ICs. As we know, in a planar mechanism, rigid bodies will be connected either by revolute pair or by prismatic pair or by some kind of higher pair. So if two bodies are connected by a revolute pair, as shown, the relative instantaneous center is the center of revolute pair. As we see here, the 1 and 2 are constituting a revolute pair. So we can see that the center of the revolute pair is the instantaneous center. So we can decide the instantaneous center just by looking at the configuration. Another example for this is the circular disk, which is rotating about the fixed center. This is also a revolute pair. So I21 can be easily rotated. Another example which we saw earlier also, that if the circular disk at which two points, at two of its point, the linear velocities were defined. So the perpendicular from the velocity vectors gave us the center of rotation. So we can easily locate the instantaneous center by inspection. These are the cases of pure rotation. Next, if two bodies are connected by prismatic pair, then the relative IC is at the infinity in the direction perpendicular to the axis of the prismatic pair. This we have already seen earlier. This is a pure translatory motion. Further, suppose we have a higher pair with some kinematic constraint that one body rolls over the other without slipping. For this arrangement, we know from this no slip condition that the velocity of two points of contact belonging to the two different bodies must be same. So the point of contact will be the relative IC between these two bodies, which are connected by a higher pair without slip. For a higher pair having both rolling and slipping over other, now we see an example of a higher pair with rolling and slipping both. We can see here that link 2 and link 3 are constituting a higher pair, which are having both rolling and slipping motion relative to each other. In this case, the relative instantaneous center lies somewhere on the common normal at the point of contact. Where on common normal? This we'll discuss later. With this information plus the application of Kennedy's theorem, we should be able to determine all the relative instantaneous centers of a planar mechanism. So we should now state Kennedy's theorem. Kennedy's theorem states that if three rigid bodies are in relative motion, then the three relative instantaneous centers are collinear. As there are three rigid bodies, then as per the formula, the number of instantaneous center will be 3. Now to prove Kennedy's theorem, let us consider three rigid bodies, 1, 2 and 3. Because we are considering the relative motion, so we assume that one of the bodies is fixed, that is body 1. These are the three bodies, 1, 2 and 3. Now by inspection, we see that at this instant, body 2 is under pure rotation with respect to body 1 about the instantaneous center I2. Similarly, body 3 is under pure rotation with respect to body 1 about instantaneous center I31. So these two instantaneous centers we can easily locate by inspection. Now let us, bodies 2 and 3 are also having relative motion with respect to each other. So let us assume that the instantaneous center is at location as shown, I23. Now if I23 is relative instantaneous center between the body 2 and 3, then it must have some velocity, whether it is considered to be on body 2 or on body 3. That is the definition of relative instantaneous center I2-3. Suppose it lies on body 2, then the velocity vector of I2-3 will be in direction perpendicular to the line joining I1-2 and I2-3 as shown here. But if I2-3 lies on body 3, then the velocity vector of I2-3 will be in the direction perpendicular to the line joining I3-1 and I2-3 as shown here. But these two directions are different. So we have a contradiction here. These two vectors of I2-3 can act in same direction only if I2-3 lies on this line somewhere, either here or either here. Then only the rotation about I2-1, if I consider it to be a point on body 2, will be perpendicular to this line. And if I consider it to be a point on body 3, is rotating about I3-1, also is perpendicular to this line. So these two vectors can have the same direction, which is the necessary condition for it to be the relative instantaneous center I2-3. So we have proved Kennedy's theorem of three centers by contradiction. So this is all about today's video. In next video, we'll be doing some problems relative to instantaneous center.